When you watch a movie on your favorite streaming platform, all you need is your PC or smartphone's web browser and an internet connection. This is because all the movies available to you are hosted by the streaming platform. It provides you with this catalog of movies on demand as a service, and that's what your subscription pays for. So when we say a service is in the cloud, it means that the means of production to provide that service are hosted by the cloud provider. The cloud changes the way we consume and manage IT resources. It is a model where you consume IT resources just like any utility, such as water, electricity, gas, and on-demand movies. Most popular cloud service providers are AWS for Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, and Google Cloud. The first thing to understand about the cloud is that it's primarily an economic model with four essential characteristics. A cloud service is, first and foremost, an on-demand service. This means that a client should be able to request any type of resource at any time, and the cloud's response must be immediate. This is possible because everything in the cloud is automated. Then, the cloud is a measurable service, meaning both the client and the provider must be able to measure the usage of resources. For the client, this allows them to understand what resources they are consuming. This is especially important because in the cloud model, clients only pay for what they use. Cloud computing also allows for the pooling and sharing of resources. A cloud service provider has vast IT resources that are shared among all its clients according to demand, and no one knows where the consumed resource is located. This pooling enables elasticity in cloud resources, automatically adjusting resources to demand fluctuations. Finally, elasticity of cloud resources is the ability to dynamically allocate resources based on needs, whether it's scaling up or down, for a short or long duration and doing so quickly. There are several types of cloud services categorized based on the technical layer they offer. There are three usage models for the cloud, each playing a specific role. Infrastructure as a service provides infrastructure services, such as VMs, network, or storage services. In this model, the user of the service manages middleware and applications, while the rest is handled by the cloud provider. The target audience is mainly IT operators. A platform as a service provides not only technical infrastructure, like infrastructure as a service, but also integrated software components such as middleware instances and runtime environments, like application servers or databases. In this model, the client manages applications, allowing him to focus on application development. Developers are the primary audience for platform as a service. Finally, software as a service delivers ready-to-use applications that run on the cloud provider's infrastructure and are accessible through the client's browser. Examples include online email or office applications. Here, the end users are the target audience. Now, let's discuss hosting modes because the cloud comes in various hosting modes, and each mode impacts the essential characteristics of the cloud. With the public cloud, the technical infrastructure is externalized to a third-party provider, making IT resources open to all and shared among multiple users. It's the flagship model of the cloud, as we've seen so far. Regarding the private cloud, it reserves all resources exclusively for one company's use. The main limitation here is the resources and means the company allocates to its private cloud. The primary benefit of a private cloud is addressing legal requirements, security needs, or the company's desire to maintain control over its technical infrastructure. Then, the hybrid cloud combines both private and public cloud resources, allowing dedicated internal resources and external public resources. The goal is to handle occasional load spikes, such as during the holiday season. Finally, the multi-cloud refers to the practice of using multiple public cloud providers, instead of relying on a single cloud provider. It allows businesses to select the best provider for each specific workload, business need, or objective. I hope this video helped you get the hang of cloud stuff. If it did, smash that subscribe button so you don't miss my next videos. See you soon.